Dear students, in the previous class, we have estimated earliest starting time, earliest finishing time, and the latest starting time and latest finishing time for an activity which is having one time estimate. What is the meaning of one time estimate? Only one time is given. That is, when you say activity A, for example, 9 weeks, it is exactly 9 weeks. But in this lecture, we are going to find the schedule of the whole project where the 3 time estimate is given. What is the 3 time estimate? I will explain in the lecture. Other way, instead of saying 3 time estimate, we can say the activity duration is uncertain. Okay. Whenever the activity duration is uncertain, there are different way to find out the expected duration of an activity. So, these details I will cover in this lecture. So, the agenda for this lecture is project scheduling for uncertain activities, then finding expected duration of an activity, then finding the variance of an activity, at last finding the probability of the path meeting the deadline. So, these topics we will cover in this lecture. The reference for this lecture is from the book Anderson et al. So, in this session, we consider the details of the project scheduling for a problem involving new product research and development. Whenever the project is something innovative, something new, the project activity time cannot be estimated perfectly. That is the reason this example has taken for this session. So, here what we are going to do, there will be an activity, right? There will be a 3 time estimate will be given: optimistic time, most likely time, and pessimistic time. Okay. That we will be covering in this lecture. Because of many activities in such a project would have never been attempted, the project manager want to account for uncertainties in the activity times. Let us see how project scheduling can be conducted with the uncertain activity times. The problem which I have taken for this session is, a company has manufactured industrial vacuum cleaning system for many years. The company's new product research team suggested that the company consider manufacturing a cordless vacuum cleaner without wire. Okay. The new product could contribute to the company's expansion into the household market. Management hopes that the new product can be manufactured at a reasonable cost, and that its portability and no card convenience will make it extremely attractive to potential consumers. So, what questions the management is asking? The management wants to study the feasibility of manufacturing the product. For that, they are going for a feasibility study. The feasibility study will provide a recommendation on the action to be taken. To complete this activity, information must be obtained from the firm's research and development department, product testing department, manufacturing and cost estimating, and market research groups. The question need to be answered is, how long will it take to complete this feasibility study? So, to complete the feasibility study, the activity list is given: activity A, B, C, D up to J. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, there is a 10 activity. Activity A and B is not having any precedence. C, D, E having precedence A. Like that, there are other activities which has preceding activities. So, the precedence constraint need to be considered while drawing the network. So, what I am going to do? I am going to draw the network for this. So, activity, so I will start from here. Start. activity A and B is not having any predecessor. So, I am writing. So, this is A, this is B. C and D, for activity C and D and E also, the predecessor is A. So, for C, for D, similarly for E, okay. For activity F, predecessor is C. For activity G, predecessor is D. For activity H, predecessor is B and E. So, for activity I, predecessor is for activity J, the predecessor is F, G and I. Okay. There are different ways for drawing the network. One method is called activity on node, another method is called activity on arc. Here the activity I have written in node, many software packages follow this activity on node. The way I have drawn is this activity I have mentioned on node. There are some network in that we will mention activity, for example, activity A, this is activity on arc, okay. So, but we are following activity on node. So, this is the way, there should be a arrow. This is the network by considering all the precedence constraint. So, this I have brought it. So, we are starting from here, I have written all the activities, finally there is a finish. Okay, start and finish only for my understanding, the start and finish is not the activities. Okay, A, B, these are the first activities. Okay. Now, the project scheduling for uncertain activities. Once we develop the project network, like what I have discussed in the previous slide, we will need information on the time required to complete each activity. This information is used in calculating the total time required to complete the project and in the scheduling of specific activities. For a repeat projects such as construction and maintenance projects, the manager may have the experience and historical data necessary to provide accurate activity time estimates. However, for a new or unique project, estimating the time for each activity may be quite difficult. In fact, in many cases, activity times are uncertain. Activity times are uncertain and are best described by a range of possible values rather than by one specific time estimate. In the previous lecture, we have found the schedule of an each activity by having one specific time estimate, but in this lecture, we are going to estimate the project schedule by considering for an activity which is having range of possible values. So, in these instances, the uncertain activity times are treated as random variables with associated probability distributions. For example, say this is an activity. Okay. The activity completion time may follow any distribution. Okay. So, the probability of completing say 5 days may be 0.1. Probability of completing the same activity for completing 6 days say 0.5. Okay. So, probability of completing this activity say 0.4. Okay. So, 8 completing this activity 0.1. So, what is happening? This time estimate t is following an empirical distribution. It can follow any distribution. It can mean it can this activity duration time may follow normal distribution, or it can follow uniform distribution, or it can follow beta distribution. That is what we are going to discuss in this class. So, in this class what we have going to assume that the activity completion time follow beta distribution. So, now we are going to discuss about the 3 time estimate for an activity. So, we are going to call it as A, M, B. To incorporate uncertain activity times into the analysis, we need to obtain 3 time estimate for each activity. So, the first time estimate called optimistic time, A. What is that? The minimum activity time if everything progress ideally, if there is no interruption for completing. So, the optimistic time is a minimum activity time. Okay. Then second one is the most probable time, M, that is the most probable activity time under normal conditions. The third time estimate is the pessimistic time, B, the maximum activity time if substantial delays are encountered. So, these 3 time estimate follow the distribution called, we are assuming this 3 time estimate follow distribution called beta distribution. What I have written here, this picture is beta distribution time. Look at this, the minimum time is optimistic time, A. Look at the B, right? The longest time is called pessimistic time. So, in between there will be a time called most likely time. So, in x axis there is a possible activity duration, in y axis probability. So, the mean of this beta distribution is optimistic time plus 4 time most likely time plus pessimistic time divided by 6. So, this mean formula for beta distribution, if the project completion time follow say uniform distribution, then mean will be a plus b by 2. If it is following normal distribution, mean will be mean itself. Okay. So, since we assumed that these 3 time estimate follow beta distribution, the formula for mean is this one, optimistic time plus 4 time most likely time plus pessimistic time divided by 6. Instead of this, if the activity completion time follow simply an empirical distribution. So, for that how will you find the mean time? So, E of x equal to summation of x into p of x, x is the project completion time, p of x is the probability. So, what we have seen in the previous slide, what I have written here, you see that? So, here the mean is 5 multiplied by 0.1 plus 6 multiplied by 0.5 plus 7 multiplied by 0.4 plus 8 multiplied by 0.1. Okay. This is the way to get the mean of an empirical distribution. You see that for each activity, we have the optimistic time, pessimistic time, most likely time, most probable time. See, the optimistic time is the minimum time, pessimistic time is the maximum time, most probable time is in between. So, how to find out the mean or expected time for an activity? To illustrate the PERT CPM procedure with uncertain activity times, let us consider the optimistic, most probable and pessimistic time estimates for the project activities which is given in the previous table. So, the formula for finding the mean of a beta distribution is optimistic time plus 4 time most likely time, most probable time plus pessimistic time upon 6. Now, I will tell you how to find out the expected time for each activity. For example, activity A. For activity A, we see that the most probable time is 5 weeks with range from 4 optimistic time plus 12 weeks pessimistic time. So, the formula for finding the mean is A plus 4 m plus B by upon 6, that is a 4 plus. So, this 4 multiplied by this 4 comes from the formula 4 multiplied by 5 plus 12 upon 6. So, what is this meaning of this 6 is? If the activity could be repeated a large number of times, so the average time for the activity is nothing but this 6. The average time is 6. Once we know the average, then we have to find out the variance of that activity also. So, when uncertain activity times, we can use the variance to describe the dispersion or variation in the activity time values. So, the variance of the activity time is given by the formula for beta distribution is sigma square equal to B minus optimistic time upon 6 whole square. If it is an empirical distribution, what is the variance formula? Variance is sigma of x minus mu whole square P of x. Okay, here mu is the mean. So, before finding the variance, you should know the mean value. Already I told you the mean is E of x is sigma of x into P of x. Okay. First you have to find the mu, then you have to find the variance if the activity completion time follow empirical distribution. But here we assumed that the activity time follow beta distribution. So, the variance formula for beta distribution is B minus A upon 6 whole square. So, the difference between the pessimistic and optimistic time estimates greatly affect the value of the variance. So, large difference in these two values reflect a higher degree of uncertainty in the activity time. So, the measure of uncertainty, that is the variance of an activity A denoted by sigma A square, is nothing but 12 minus this 12 minus 4 whole square, 4 upon 6 whole square. So, 8 upon 6 whole square, this is 1.78. If you want to know the standard deviation, you have to take the square root of this. So, what we have done by using the mean and variance formula, so this 3 time estimate is converted into a single time estimate for each activity. Okay. For example, activity A, we have the 3 time estimate 4, 6, 4, 5, 12, that is converted into single time estimate 6. For that activity, we found the variance 1.78. Like that, I have found the expected time and variance for all the activities. Now, we will find the earliest start and earliest finishing time using forward pass method that I have discussed in the previous lecture. So, we start from 0, earliest starting time is 0. So, 6. So, here 6 plus 3, 9. So, 6 plus 5, 11. So, here 6 plus 3, 9. So, here 0 plus 2, 2. Here 9 plus 2, 11. Here 11 plus 3, 14. Here you see there are two way to reach activity H, 9 and 2. So, we have to consider the largest value 9, largest value between 9 and 2. So 9 plus 4 is 13. Okay. So this 13 plus 2 is 15. Now you see for activity J, there are three ways. We can come from activity F, G and I, which is the largest one? Largest one is 15. So 15 plus 2 is 17. So for this project, the total time taken to complete all the activities 17 weeks. Okay. As we know, this represents earliest starting time, this represents earliest finishing time. Now, using the backward pass technique, I am going to find out the latest starting and latest finishing time. So, I start from the last activity, that is J. So, the latest finishing time is 17. So, the latest starting time will be 17 minus 2, 15. So, here it is a 15. 15 minus 2 is 13. So, 13 minus 4 is 9. So, it is 9. 9 minus 3 is 6. So, here it is 9. 9 minus 2 is 7. Now, we will come to activity J. It is 15. 15 minus 3 is 12. So, here it is F. For F it is a 15. 15 minus 2 is 13. So, here also 13. 13 minus 3 is 10. So, for activity D 12. 12 minus 5 is 7. Now, I have to write the latest finishing time for activity A. So, what are the succeeding activity C, D, E? So, I had here the earliest starting time is 10, earliest starting time is 7, earliest starting time is 6. So, what I had to do? I had to find out the minimum earliest starting time. So, that minimum earliest starting time will be the latest finishing time of preceding activity. So, the 6 will be the latest finishing time. So, 6 minus 6 is 0. Now, we have to find out the critical path. So, wherever the float is 0, that path is critical path. What is the formula for float? Float means slack, the previous class. That is latest starting time minus earliest starting time. Okay. So, for this, when you look at this here, it is 15, 15. So, here slack is 0, here also it is 0, 9 comma 9 0, 6 comma 6 is 0, here also 0. So, the critical path is this one, this, this, this. So, using different color, this, 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 this. So, all the activities in the critical path is called critical activities because the float or the slack is 0. That means, these activities cannot be delayed at all. If we delay that activity, the project duration will be extended beyond 17 weeks. Now, what are the critical activities? Activity A, I go back, yes, this is activity A, second one. So, when you find float activity E, yes, activity E, the next one is activity H, I will go back, activity H, next one is I and J. So, I and J, these are the critical activities. And apart from this critical part, the uncritical activities, we have the schedule for earliest starting time and latest starting time and earliest finishing time and latest finishing time. So far we have found the expected total completion time. Now we are going to consider another element apart from the mean. We are going to find out the variability in the project completion time. So the critical path AEHIJ resulted in an expected total project completion time 17 weeks. So the mean is, the mean project completion time is 17 weeks, but we have to supply the variance also apart from the 17. However, see, the variation in activities can cause variation in the project completion time. The 17 is there. So what we have to do? We have to find out the variance. We have to sum the variance of all the activities which are in the critical path. That is, we have to find out the variance of activity A, E, H, I, J. We have to sum the variance. Then we have to take the square root of that variance. So that will be the standard deviation of that critical path. So variation in non-critical activities ordinarily has no effect on the project completion time, because the slack time associated with these activities, because there will be some slack time, there will be a positive slack time, so that won't affect our project completion time. However, if a non-critical activity is delayed long enough to expend its slack time, it becomes part of a new critical path and may affect the project completion time. But generally, we are concerned about the activities which are in the critical path. So the variability leading to a longer than expected total time for a critical activities will always extend the project completion time. Conversely, variability that result in a shorter than expected total time for the critical activities will reduce the project completion time unless other activities become critical. So what is the point here is, whenever we provide the mean total completion time, we have to provide the variance of that activities also. Now we are going to find out the variability in project completion time. For a project involving uncertain activity times, the probability that the project can be completed within the specified amount of time is helpful for managerial information. To understand the effect of variability on project management, let us observe four paths through the project network. For example, path 1, AE, this one, AE, H, I, J. This is one path. There is another path, ACFJ. ACFJ. Third path we can consider ADGJ. The fourth path we can consider BH, start from here, BHIJ. So we have considered four paths. There will be a different total completion time for all these four paths. So what we are going to do? We are going to find out the total completion time for all these four paths, and we are going to find out the variance of these each path. Okay, that's what we are going to do. So first we will take the path 1, AEHIJ, this one, AEHIJ. This is our critical path, what we have found, 17 weeks. So let the random variable Ti denote the total time to complete path I. So the expected value of Ti is equal to the sum of the expected times of the activities along the path. So what is that? Here 6 plus 3 9 plus 4 13 plus 2 5 15 plus 2, so it is 17. So we got 17 weeks. So what we have to do now? We have to find out the variance of this path for completing this project within 17 weeks. So the variance of this Ti is the sum of the variance of the activities along the path I. So what we have to do? So we have to sum the variance. You should be very careful, we should not add the standard deviation, we have to sum the variance. Okay. So when you, because already we have the variance data with us, so 1.78, 0.11, 0.69, 0.03, 0.11, so we will be getting 2.72. So where this sigma a square, sigma e square, sigma h square, sigma I square and sigma j square are the variance of activities which are in that path. Okay. The formula for sigma 1 square, that means variability of the path 1, is based on the assumption that activity times are independent. This assumption is important. So, these activity times is not having any dependency, these are independent. If 2 or more activities are dependent, the formula provides only an approximation of the variance of the path completion time. Closer the activities are to being independent, the better the approximation. Here assumption is all the activities are independent. Knowing that the standard deviation is the square root of the variance, we compute the standard deviation of the path 1, and that value is 1.65. Already we know the mean is 17. So, plus or minus, if you want to have 1 sigma, 2 sigma completion time, here we can write 1.65. Okay. Here if you want, you can write 1 sigma, sometime 2 sigma, sometime 3 sigma. Okay. Now, we are going to find out the probability that a path of activities will be completed within a specified time. Assuming that the distribution of the path completion time T1 follows normal distribution, we can compute the probability that a path of activities will be completed within a specified time. So, what point here I am discussing? You see that the project completion time follow normal distribution. So, for path 1, the mean is 17 and the standard deviation is 1.615. Okay. Now, suppose that the management allotted 20 weeks for the project. Okay. Suppose the management says, what is the probability that the project will be completed within 20 weeks. So, what we have to do? We have to find out the area of this shaded portion. That is what we are going to do. So, this area will give you the answer for probability of completing this path within 20 days. But you see, what is the probability of completing this activities in 17 days? 0.5, because we found the average, because the 17 is the average time. What will be probability is a 0.5. But if you want to complete this project on 20 days, obviously the probability will be more than 0.5. We are asking for the probability that the T1 less than or equal to 20, which corresponds graphically to the shaded area in the figure. So, what I am meaning this? This is 17, this is 1.65, so this is 20. So, we have to find out area of this shaded figure. So, to find the area, there are two ways. One is directly we can find the area of this distribution with the help of Excel. Otherwise, we can find the area with the help of table also, normal table. So, if you are using a normal table, so this 20 has to be converted into z scale. So, what is the formula for z? X minus mu by sigma. So, here x is 20, mean is 17, sigma is 1.65. So, when you simplify this, you will get 1.82. So, in a table where the z value is 1.82, the left side area will give you the probability of completing this path within 20 days. Using z equal to 1.82 and the table for the normal distribution, we find that the probability of path 1 meeting this 20 week is 0.9656. This probability we can find with the help of Excel also. So, now I am going to open Excel. Now, I am going to find out area of a normal distribution using Excel. I know the mean equal to 17, standard deviation is 1.65, already I have found the value of z is 1.82. So, here the value of x, for example, x equal to in B6, you write x equal to tab 20. Okay. Now, what I am going to find out, when x is 20, what will be the area? So, what I mean here is, suppose there is a normal distribution, the mean is 17, standard deviation is 1.65. If x is 20, that is, what will be the area on the left hand side? So, in our problem context, what is the probability of completing this project within 20 weeks? So, we need to find out the area. In Excel, there are two ways we can find the area of a normal distribution. One is norm dot s dot dst. So, directly we can find out area of a standardized normal distribution. Otherwise, there is another function, norm dot dist. This you need not standardize, you can directly, you can find the value of the probability of the normal distribution. First I will use the second one, norm dot dst. So, my cursor is in B7 equal to norm dot dst. See, what is, I need x is my 20, select 20, mean is 17, standard deviation is 1.65, comma. You see that this is a continuous distribution. We need the cumulative value. So, click true, close the bracket. So, the area is 0.96. What is the meaning of this 0.96? There is a 96% probability chance that the project can be completed within 20 days. By then, next I will use the other formula, norm dot s dot dst. So, equal to norm dot s dot dst. Now, we have to substitute the value of z value. So, the value of z is 1.82 comma cumulative. Close the bracket. So, this is the way, you see that both the values are same. This is the way to use Excel for finding area of a normal distribution. Now, I will go back to the lecture. Now, you see that the area for completing within 20 week is 0.9656. Let us repeat the calculation of the expected completion time and variance in completion time for other paths through the project work. So, I have created a table, this we have found already. Similarly, for path 2, I found the expected completion time is 13, standard deviation is 2.03. Then if you find the area, it is 0.999. With the help of Excel, you can find out the area. Then path 3, the mean is 16, the probability of completing this project in 20 weeks is 0.97. In path 4, it is a 10, expected completion time is 10, standard deviation is 1.27, the probability of completing in 20 days is 0.99. So, what we are inferring from this table, path 2 and path 4, see this, path 2 and path 4, the probability is 0.99, that is path 2 and 4 are virtually guaranteed to be completed by 20 weeks deadline, and path 3 has the probability of 0.9783 of meeting the 20 week deadline. So, in this lecture, I have discussed about project scheduling for uncertain activities. Then we have found the expected duration of an activity, assuming that the activity duration follow beta distribution. Then I have found the variance of an activity. Here also the assumption is that activity duration follow beta distribution. You should remember one point, that activity duration follow beta distribution, but the project completion time follow normal distribution. That point you should remember. Then at last, what I have done, I have found the probability of the path meeting the deadline. So, here I want to insist the point that the probability of completing the deadline, that is project completion time follow normal distribution. Thank you very much.